We'll have members of the Public Land Development Corporation Board and Executive Director and staff. My name is Laura Thielen. Still getting used to the Senator portion. Former Chair of the Department of Land and Natural Resources. Thank you for the opportunity to testify today. I've submitted some written testimony, but I guess I just want to touch on some points. A lot of people today testify in front of you about positive things that can be done. Jim McCulley was talking about the redevelopment of the Hilo industrial area and the Banyan Drive resort areas. You do not need an exemption from existing state land use laws or county zoning laws to redevelop those areas. They are already zoned and classified for urban and resort use. Dino Gimoto was talking about agricultural accessory facilities, value-added processing, agricultural operations. You do not need an exemption from county zoning or state land use laws to build those facilities on agricultural lands. They are authorized. Sheldon Zane was talking about the need to repair existing infrastructure, our roads, our bridges. You do not need an exemption from state land use laws or county zoning to repair those facilities. Nor do you need an exemption to enter into public-private partnerships for development. This board heard testimony from across the entire state, and one of the premier complaints that you were asked to address in your administrative rules was the fact that the Public Land Development Corporation is exempt from state, local land use laws and zoning. And that's the biggest fear that people have. If all you want to do is do the positive redevelopment that people have talked about today, or that is being pictured up there on the screen, all of that is allowed under the existing zoning, and you can follow those rules. And you had the opportunity to adopt rules that said that you would abide by these key land use and zoning laws. And you did not do so. In fact, the amendments that you made actually made it worse. Because under your original draft rules, Section 13302-25, your original draft rules actually required all PLDC projects to follow existing laws, charter provisions, and rules, and be as consistent with the county, community, or development plans for the area as is practical. So your original draft rules did commit to following some of the local zoning laws and charter provisions relating to the county, community, and development plans. But in the amendments that are before you today, you took that language out. You struck the requirement to follow existing laws, charter provisions, and rules. So you eliminated even a shadow of a commitment to follow some type of zoning. Another complaint that was heard by you as you went around the state of your administrative rules is the fact that there is no meaningful opportunity for public input when the PLDC engages in significant decision-makings about development. And I find it disappointing that even though you were fully aware about this complaint, that you chose to hold a single hearing today in Honolulu, in the middle of the day, before making a recommendation back to the board on the adoption of these rules. I think the board had the option to resolve a lot of the community concerns, and it did not address that in your rule amendments. And the board has demonstrated today in this hearing that it's more interested in expediency than in providing Hawaii residents with an opportunity for meaningful public input. And according to my interpretation of your actions today, this board has confirmed the need for the legislature to take up Act 55 again and either repeal it or significantly amend it, because we cannot rely on the board or the staff to adopt good governance processes. Thank you for your time.